then we went into workshop production. And then that became just the most extraordinary experience. In the course of casting the show, we loved Raoul. Toon said, quite rightly, I don't think an American should play this character. We have to have somebody who's other. It's just another call, you know, and Raoul just fits the bill. There's just something wonderful about him that's, it's Latin and it's working. But all the other men we saw somehow didn't read like Italian men from Italy. Somehow they all were American chorus boys of one kind or another. And every woman we saw was Fellini-esque and was very interesting. And it was Toon's idea to say, let's do it with all women. And I thought, gee, that's interesting because now I can really use them chorally and I can make the most varied choral sounds imaginable. They can be nuns, they can be sopranos, they can all be Ethel Merman. And we began to think along those lines. And then Tommy came in one day and said, you know, I think everything that you have written in this is really the set. Europe is in the music. And the reason it was is because so much of what I had written in nine was a reflection of my college years traveling around Europe, playing in Europe, soaking up German music and Italian music and French music and even Greek music. And the music paints the European landscape. And because of that, he said, we don't really need to build Europe. We can do this. I'd love to do this on a canvas. I'd love to do this. We're just in a white tile set. We're in a spa. And he unrolled a piece of paper and he said, look, see, we can have these 24 boxes here and then we'll put Raoul over here in front. And I said, well, that just looks like a conductor. I said, so they're the orchestra of women inside his mind. Well, if that's the case, then why would we have the orchestra play the overture? Let me write a vocal overture. And the only lyric will be La. And that was, again, that night I wrote the overture. It only took a night. I had the, and the next day, I literally began to teach it. So the overture came in. Now is not perhaps the time to tell the Lillian Montevecchi story, which is another story, but the overture came in, the Grand Canal came in. I had written the Grand Canal, but the opera within the Grand Canal, the Casanova opera within the Grand Canal, came in and was written during that period. And of course, I think probably the most profoundly new thing that came in, the two most profoundly new things were when I taught Anita Morris A Call from the Vatican. She sang a high C. I did not know she had a high C, and so I said, Anita, let's stop this and let me come back tomorrow. And I rewrote the last part of the song so that Anita could sing a high C. And I think the second great surprise was the entire episode and the story of Folies Bergère, which is itself a great odyssey.